Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to tonight's talk with Dave. By the way, I am a student in University of Cebu, Manila, taking up the Bachelor of Elementary Education. And for today, we will be talking about the ramification of this pandemic, especially to our dear ALS or ESL teacher and ALS student. So, I have invited an ESL teacher and an ALS student. So, I have invited two. So, first, right now, let's welcome our first guest, Miss Grace. Hi, Miss Grace. Are you there?
Hi, Dave.
Okay, it's nice to see you. Let me just unpin myself. Okay, so Miss Grace, how's life going?
Well, actually, so far, so good.
Okay, so that's good to hear, Miss Grace. Anyhow, thank you so much for accepting my invitation to this interview with me. It is a pleasure to have you this evening, Miss Grace. Thank you for that.
Yes, the pleasure is all mine, Dave.
Okay, all right. So, Miss Grace, let's start without further ado. Let's get started with our interview right now, okay? So for the first question, Miss Grace, now as an ESL teacher, what are the challenges that you have experienced during this pandemic?
Well, let me just share this to you. When this pandemic emerged in our country, you know, a lot of companies are forced to close nor declared bankruptcy, right? Because because either they are mandated by the health office to stop operating in order to control or to stem the transmission of these diseases, or they cannot keep up to the drastic drop of the economy. One of it who has been affected so much is the ESL industry. I have known that there are many ESL schools declared bankruptcy. Fortunately, our company wasn't one of them. Now, the greatest challenge that we are facing is that how we can sustain and maintain our service and quality of teaching to our students when, in fact, we were an offline class before, but now we are online. As a teacher, it's quite challenging for me to change my teaching style, especially when teaching online, because there's a quite difference between teaching online and teaching offline. Thus, I research a lot of useful teaching techniques that I can use for my online classes.
Okay, so that must be very challenging indeed for that, Miss Grace. So I've come to know that you are teaching multi-age students, is that right?
Yes, definitely. That's right, Dave.
Okay, how old are they, by the way?
Well, they're actually from young learners to adults, like 7 years old to like 40 and above.
Interesting. Imagine the gap between the ages, 7 years old to adults. Who can imagine about that? I'm teaching with younger ones and then alternating to teach with a older one. Am I right, Miss Grace?
Is that? Yes, definitely.
Okay. So right now, Miss Grace, let's move on with our second question. So, let's just check in here. Okay, what are the advantages and disadvantages of being a teacher in a multi-grade class?
Well, one of the advantages is that, you know, it hones me to be a better teacher and also to be an effective one. In line with that, it gives me a great opportunity to discover a lot of teaching techniques or methods that will be useful and will fit to the individual needs and level of my students. On the other hand, The downside of this is that knowing that this time, classes are done online. Not all students have access to the internet nor have a device to use for online class. So there are some students that will, you know, be left behind because of this pandemic.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so let me just repeat about the sentences that you gave to me a while ago, Miss Grace. You said a while ago that the advantages that you can probably get in this teaching multi-grade class is that you can hone a better teacher, or let me revise that statement. You will be a better teacher. You will be becoming a better teacher. And then with the disadvantages, you said a while ago that you're afraid that some of your students will be left behind because of the advances of the technology that we are using right now. And then there is some students who is lacking and who is not financially stable to bought a newly devices that can support their online class. Is that right, Ms. Grace?
Yes, perfectly right, Dave. Thank you.
So being that said, what is your advice and recommendations for future teachers of multi-grade classes in handling classroom management and effective teaching strategies?
I think for me, to aspiring teachers out there who's watching our interview right now, mm-hmm. Well, my advice for you future teachers, when handling a classroom management, you need to set your rules at the very beginning of the class. That's for you to avoid misbehaviors in the classroom in the future. So be proactive rather than reactive. Finally, for effective teaching strategies, you have to know your students first. For example, what type of learners are they and what are their interests? With that, you can use those information to choose what strategies will be suitable for them or for their level, rather.
That's it. Thank you for your time, Ms. Grace. It is really well stated about the experiences that you had during your time of teaching a multi-grade level class. I really appreciate the time that you have been given to us with this our interview. And yeah, thank you for your time, Ms. Grace. Have a good night.
You as well. Thank you.
And now let's welcome our second guest, Miss Bianca. Hi, Miss Bianca.
Hello, Sir Dave.
Mm-hmm. So I have something to ask you. How's life going on?
Kind of hard, but I'm doing great. How about you, sir?
Oh, I'm so fine. So far, so good, Miss Bianca. So that's good to hear. Anyhow, thank you so much for accepting my invitation to this interview with me, Miss Bianca. All right, without further ado, let's get started. Are you ready, Miss Bianca?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Just give me a couple of minutes while I'm pulling out my questionnaire for you. For my first question with you, Ms. Bianca, what are the challenges that you have been experienced during this pandemic?
Honestly, as an ALS student, a lot of challenges really bothers me in succeeding my dreams. In the near future, I really want to be an engineer, but this pandemic is really blocking my will to go to school because we need to follow the protocols, the safety protocols. And so, learning in an online class is very hard for me since I am not so familiar with PowerPoint and even the Microsoft. And also the fact that I can't able to perform well with my studies compared during face-to-face class.
Yes, very well said, Miss Bianca. Yes. I agree with you that this mode of classes right now, the modules one, the online classes that we had, are very hard to deal with because the fact that we are trained to learn in a traditional way where the a man-to-man set up, but right now we need to learn for ourselves, read our modules. Are you agreeing with me, Miss Bianca, that it is very hard?
Mm-hmm. Firmly with that, sir.
Okay, I see. So moving on for my second question for you, Miss Bianca. In here, what are the advantages and disadvantages of being a teacher or a student in a multi-grade class? And since you are a student, let me reframe the question for you. Sorry for that. What are the advantages and disadvantages of being a student in a multi-grade class?
One of the advantages is that I can manage my time well with my family. Mm-hmm. And I've learned to develop my skills in time management. Yes, and also to have some time to do my household chores. And for me, the disadvantages is just like I said like a while ago, I am really having a hard time to deal with computers and programs. So that's for me a disadvantage for this school year, this way of learning.
I just want to recapitulate the things that you've mentioned a while ago, Ms. Bianca. You said that the advantages that for this online classes set up is that you can manage your time very well, and also you have some times to relax and spend time with your family, also doing your household chores. While with the disadvantages, still you mentioned that you're having some hard time dealing with the computer setups and also the programs. Am I right, Ms. Bianca?
Yes, sir, you are right.
Okay, very well said. Yes, we can't deny the fact that most of the students, the disadvantages is just like that, the computers, how to deal with it, how to use with it. And so let's move on with our last question. For the last question, if given the chance, what would you prefer to have, attending a regular class or attending a multi-grade class? Why or why not?
I would choose attending in a multi-grade class. Mm-hmm. Because as an electrical student, I really need to learn from my classmates. And honestly, they're way older than me, because compared to their regular class, all of us need to start from the beginning, like no glimpse, or we don't have any thought of what course is this all about. And like with the multi-grade level class, most likely my classmates has already gone through some courses, and even the teacher in multi-grade class are very keen or very true in teaching us their students.
That ends our part of our interview, Miss Bianca. Very well said. I really agree of how you deliver those statements on yours, because this interview really goes about the perception of the student of how they react to this pandemic going on, and also as a student. So Miss Bianca, this ends our part. I hope you really you learned something with this interview, and have a good night for you. And yes, continue
Thank
studying
you.
And do your modules.
Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Good evening.
Okay, bye for now.